Hello and welcome to Ask the Expert. My name is Christopher and I'm your host. With me today I have Danny from our R&D department. Danny, can you talk a little bit about what you do at DynAudio?
Yes, hello, I'm Danny and I work as a driver development engineer at DynAudio. So it's basically everything is related to drivers. I've been at DynAudio for 2.5 years.
Okay.
So been involved in the LYD project, the Contour project, and now the Confidence project.
So you've done a little bit of everything?
Yeah, I've been involved in every home and pro project in DynAudio in the recent years.
And thank you for taking time out of your only day at high end to come and speak with me. And I think that we should just jump straight into some of the questions that we got regarding drive units.
Fine.
And the first one is from Brent Wilson. And Brent, he wants to know what kind of improvements you can see in our drive units as they move up in range.
Yeah. There's different facts, aspects you could look into in the different categories, but one thing is that you have normally more development time for more high end advantage where you want to do everything new and new improve of the finest details. And then there's also material cost, for example, and assembly cost. So there's a lot of different factors that you can play around with, right?
And I think some of the stuff that I know about is, you know, there's ferrite magnets you can play around with, there's neodymium magnets, and is it like that when you move up in range, we will always use the neodymium magnet, or?
Not necessarily, but it has some nice features of the magnetic strength of neodymium is way higher than on ferrite, so you can do some stuff that is nearly impossible in ferrite.
Okay.
Or will be very big.
And of course, size does matter, right? It's, you don't want a loudspeaker that this
maybe,
big.
Maybe you don't want that. But I have seen some.
Yeah, you see a lot of stuff at high end. There's no doubt about that. So, are there any other factors that are or especially interesting to talk about when you move up in range? Is it the materials? I know we use MSP.
Yeah, that's all used. That's always used. So it's not like we have different grades of MSP.
No,
we have a very good basic level, and then if it can be in different shapes or different thicknesses around different ranges. But
So it's. There's some magnets. What about voice coil? Is there anything?
They can also be like, you know, for example, on the Confidence series, we're using glass fiber in different configurations depending what we need. So like, for example, like 3 layers in the woofers of the Confidence 60.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is that something new for DynAudio?
Yeah, the number of layers and the way we do it is different to what we've done before.
What about
before.
The material, glass fiber?
Glass fiber has been used also in the Contour series and for some of the Lyd products.
So the next question, Danny, is from Howie Xerxes, and Howie is actually someone that we in the social media team know pretty well because we have a long dialogue with him. He's very fond of our Special 40 loudspeakers. So Howie's question is about the hybrid magnet that you find in the Special 40's woofer. And his question is, can we expect to see that in, for instance, a Focus XD type of speaker?
Yeah, of course I can't comment on future products, but if you should talk a little about the hybrid magnet system in Special 40, which is actually in the Special 40 is an evolvement of the, or what could you say, evolution of the old Confidence woofers.
Okay.
So it was also a hybrid magnet system with a neodymium inside a cup and then an XL ferrite magnet, as we call it.
Okay.
Pretty,
but what is this special thing about it? Because I remember hearing something about it being one of the better drive units that we've in that size class that we've developed.
We actually took the Confidence C1 driver and looked at where could we improve the performance. So and then we looked to the magnet system, voice coil, spider, and all the parts. Where could we do improvements? So that's basically where the Special 40 woofer ended up being.
What's Is there any like specific areas that you can talk about where you did some changes?
Yeah, we
some
did upgrades? Optimizations on the magnet system, on all parameters. Yeah. So I don't know if I should talk into all the details about
a little detail.
A little
okay,
detail
yeah.
is okay. So. So there's technical terms are there's BL symmetry and
a lot of different stuff. I guess.
And the field distribution in the magnet gear and stuff like that we worked on. So in simulations and then prototyping and stuff. So
you also talked about the voice coil and the spider, right?
Yeah. So we also did improvements to that as well. So
when you have a project like taking a already very good woofer as you found in the C1 and you have to improve on that, how long does that take? I guess it's not something that you just wake up one day and have an idea.
We had a very different ideas to where we could go and what we wanted to try. Then we tried different directions and made a lot of simulations and we figured out which way
we wanted to take it.
So that, I don't know the whole process, but maybe from the start to the beginning, a year or something like that.
A year?
Yeah.
And so. I guess that in a process like this, with the facilities that we have, there's a lot of simulations. There's a lot of, okay, let's get this into Jupiter to our measuring facility and try and figure out how does it actually perform.
Yeah.
And listening afterwards.
Yeah, also that. So there's a lot of different aspects to it from there. So.
And... it's in the Special 40 right now, and as you said, we can't really comment on where a woofer like this could end up. We like to keep stuff like that close to the chest, right? So I think that we should move on to another question, which is about surrounds. And that's from Matthew. And what Matthew is asking is what kind of surround shapes that we like to use or we've tested. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, in Dyn Audio we have been using a lot of different shapes. It could be like a circular, or there could be a elliptical surround, or the new, what we call the horizon surround on the Confidence. It really comes down to what you want the driver to do in terms of excursion, frequency response, and how the interaction between the surround and the cone geometry and all the parameters. So you have to take into consideration what do you want from the driver when you also decide what surround you want to use.
So it's about looking at this driver has to perform at a certain level under a certain set of circumstances and then figuring out
what do we need to do to the design to make it do that. So that's again simulations and
a trip to Jupiter. You're talking about the new horizon shape that we're using. Can you talk a little bit about what's special with that one?
We have made a surround that blends into the baffle. Together with the what is the name of that? I guess it's just we call it covering. The surround is made specifically for this new mid-range. We work on all the parameters that we wanted for this mid-range. We took what we knew from our old mid-ranges, for example, from Contour, and then again we wanted to improve on every part. The surround was one of the parts.
And what kind of, you're talking about it blending into the covering, to the baffle, what kind of advantages does that offer?
One thing is what the tweeter sees of obstruction, so to say. So a sudden change in geometry will make reflections or diffractions of the sound. So this way the tweeter will have a nice view, a flat view from the... also we wanted to work on the so-called first resonant mode of the surround. So we wanted to suppress this as much as possible. So we worked on the geometry to help us achieve that.
One of the things that I start thinking about is that I've seen the surround and it has some sharp edges. What does that do for the excursion of the cone?
We have worked on the geometry to allow it the excursion that we need in the application.
Yeah.
It's a mid-range, so it doesn't need it to be able to move to plus minus 20 millimeters.
No.
Because mid-range is maybe moving depending on the level and how it's implemented, but in a much lower range. So.
And is it... So that was the Horizon mid-range unit, right, where we had this very special surround. Is there any of the newer projects that we've done where we have an equally special shape?
I think this is the most not circular-ish surround we have made. But as I said, different shapes. So, for example, elliptical in the contour range.
And as you said earlier, it really depends on the application,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it does.
I want to continue talking a little bit about the materials that we use. We've covered, we talked about MSP, that we've used that throughout all of our drive units, right? We've talked about the voice coils, and we've talked about magnets. But I actually want to go a little bit back to talking about the kind of material that we use for voice coils, because that's something that Matthew also asked about. And you mentioned that we use, was it three different types
of
material for voice coils?
For voice coil formers or voice coil wire?
Both.
Both. we're using two different kind of materials for the voice coil wire. So it's aluminium or copper.
I think that where this train stops for me is that I'm maybe not entirely sure what the difference between the wire and the former is.
Okay. It's voice coils basically consist of two or three parts, as how you see it.
Yeah.
You have the voice coil former, which is where you attach your cone and the spider, and also the voice coil wire is attached to the voice coil former.
Okay.
So the former could be made of like glass fiber, as we talked about earlier, or titanium, or aluminium, or Kapton, or there's
all
sorts of different
weird stuff.
Yeah. Then for wire materials, normally we use aluminium or copper, mostly aluminium. So
different materials, and again, it's for the application that you're using.
Yeah, depends on what to.
And so just. Again, so I start to understand the difference between a wire and a former.
Yeah.
The wire that goes around the former, then,
and
the former's purpose is that just to keep things in place.
It holds the wire as where it needs to be, and it also is a neat way to attach the other parts, so to say.
Cool. And it's the thing. I hear a lot that one of the things that we emphasize a lot is testing different materials, constantly trying out new stuff.
Yeah.
And I guess we do the same with this.
Yeah, yeah. Also that. As I said, we ended up with three layers of glass fiber in the Confidence 60 woofer. So that's by testing different materials like titanium, aluminium, glass fibers, thicknesses of glass fiber, types of glass fiber.
Yeah.
You can go totally crazy in all the materials if you want.
Yeah.
So it's also narrowing
down.
Totally
crazy?
Sometimes. We have to at some point narrow it down to.
Yeah. Someone comes and says, "Okay, playtime's over."
Yeah.
Cool. Danny, I think that we managed to talk a little bit about all the questions that we have for today.
That's good.
So I think I'm going to say thank you for joining us and let you. Go and experience high-end a little bit more.
Thank you.
There's a lot to watch here. And I think that if you are in Munich, if you are close to the high-end show, you should come and have a listen to the new Confidence. We're previewing it here. Danny made most of the units that you can find in it. So come give it a listen and see you later.